Dag Fitzek, welcome back to the channel. You seemed to enjoy the previous GoPro video, so you get another GoPro video. Star Trails, an awesome technique to capture the movement of our planet in space, is a technique in photography and videography that's been around for ages. You used to have to shoot individual long exposure photos and then stitch them together with an application like StarStax, for example, which I've made videos about in the past. But in the later GoPro generations, you have a preset that is built in and makes it plug and play. So that's what this video is about. Talk about some do's and don'ts and my preferred settings on this Hero 11. Let's go. Now, this effect is especially cool if you live in a city with an airport near you. I live in London, so there's always an airport around because I don't know if you know this, but London has 6 main active airports, which is quite a lot. So there's always something going on in the sky. If you're going for dark skies, move away from cities, obviously, where you can use longer exposures and get more star stuff. But in my opinion, in this footage, the airplanes and the helicopters add quite a bit of interesting visual effects to this footage. So the way to set up on the GoPro is truly simple. You power on the camera, you go to time-lapse mode, and then swipe down to the preset called Star Trails, and then you use the following settings. Trail length set to max. If you go on long, it will kind of create like a comet tail. If it's on max, it will just keep that from beginning to end. But this is a stylistic choice that you have to make here. Play with that a bit, see what you prefer. Then set your exposure to, if you're in a city, probably between 2 and 10 seconds. If you're in a dark sky with no light pollution, you can go longer to 30 seconds. You will get much more starlight hitting the sensor and create more starry sky footage. But as you can see in this footage here, 30 second exposure in London, way too bright. Most cities will be way too bright. There's just too much light hitting the sensor for too long and it blows out the bottom of the footage. Yes, you get longer trails and more starlight, but this, in my opinion, is entirely unusable unless you crop out the city. So keep that in mind. Do a little test shot before you commit to a 2-hour long shoot, obviously, otherwise you might waste an entire evening of shooting. Set your resolution as high as possible on the Hero 11. It's 5.3K and use the 4:3 aspect ratio so you can decide where to crop your footage in post. Then use the scheduled capture if you want and set your limit or your duration to no limit. I just let it run until the battery dies, which the last time I tried was about an hour and a half of recording in freezing cold temperatures. I think if you're in a warmer environment, the GoPro will last longer, but obviously the best thing to do is just plug an external battery in if you want extended shooting times. Set the timer to 3 seconds so you don't move the camera when you start shooting, and do not use the digital zoom. I said this in the previous video, it really wrecks the quality, so you just keep that to 1x. Under ProTune settings, you want to set your ISO min and your ISO max to 800. That's the preset and it worked quite well for me. I find the noise levels, especially on the Hero 11, very, very decent considering how small that sensor is and how high that ISO value is. So well done, GoPro. And that's pretty much it. If you want to get some high quality GoPro educational content, check out my buddy Jake Rich's channel. He has been killing it on the GoPro front. I've listed it down below. If you have any future video requests or comments or questions about it, drop them in the questions down here. Check out my courses. And that's it. May the clouds forever be in your favor. Goodbye.